Hello everyone, I hope you're good, you're fine, and you are studying also in this period of lockdown. Now we have already done the first part of your second chapter of the Beehive, that is the Sound of Music, and today we are going to do the second part of chapter 2, that is the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. So we are going to do this one, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. I think everybody must have heard about Bismillah Khan, the famous person of Varanasi. And we are lucky to have him in our city, that is the city of Varanasi, this ancient city of Varanasi. And in the, I think here is the picture of Bismillah Khan. You can see it here. He used to play Shehnai. There are many famous faces. Like here you can see Zakir Hussain, the famous tabla player. Then Pandit Ravi Shankar. Okay. And many, all these are the famous musicians of India. So in this lesson, chapter 2, the Sound of Music, and the second part, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan, is again you will enjoy when I will explain you, and you will know about the life of Bismillah Khan. Now first of all, let me tell you the background. Now everybody must have heard about Emperor Aurangzeb. He was from a very famous dynasty, and that was the Mughal dynasty. So Emperor Aurangzeb, I think everybody must have heard, and he had banned the playing of pungai. Now pungai was a type of instrument, musical instrument. You can see here, you can see in the second page, you can see pungai, and then here Shehnai, you can see it. So at that time Shehnai was not in use, it was pungai. The people used to play pungai at that time. But the worst thing about pungai is that it used to have a very unpleasant noise. It used to have a shrill noise. Okay, so that was the reason that why Aurangzeb banned the playing of pungai in the palace, because that musical instrument, it had a sharp and unpleasant sound. So he banned it. But then it was revived by a barber. Revived means it was brought back to life by a barber in his court with some improvisation. That means he had improved, and now that pungai name has been turned into Shehnai. So that barber, he thought to improve it. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem. So he was thinking ki why he did not like, in fact, that Emperor Aurangzeb had banned the playing of pungai, but he cannot resist his order. So he thought to improve it. He thought to improve that musical instrument at pungai. He thought of improving it, and finally he did some experiment. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem. He made several horns on its body. He played on it, closing and opening some of these holes. And finally, it produced a very sweet sound. And that musical instrument was named as Shehnai. Now, barber, he played it before the royalty. It needed a name. Now that he did not took actually pungai. He took a what he took? He took a natural hollow stem. He made 7 holes, and he started playing it. And from there, a very melodious music was produced. Now, he needed some name of that musical instrument. And finally, what its name was kept? Its name was kept as Shehnai, because it was brought by a player who was a Nai. Nai means barber. And that musical instrument, that natural hollow musical instrument, it was produced, it was for the first time it was played in Shah's chamber. That's why Nai and Shah chambers. So it was for the first time it was played in Shah's chamber, and that's why its name was kept Shehnai. We all know that the name Shehnai was new at that time, and the sound of Shehnai today also is considered auspicious. Auspicious means promising to bring good fortune. So the sound of Shehnai nowadays also is considered as auspicious. That means it brings good fortune, it brings good luck to us. And nowadays you can see in India it is played in temples and at the wedding in North, especially in North India, in UP, in Bihar and many other places in North India, it is played during the time of wedding. And of course, this Shehnai is still, you can find that it is played in some of the places, in some of the religious places, in temples, you can see that people are playing Shehnai. And it was Ustad Bismillah Khan who has brought it into the classical stage. Now, Aurangzeb died many years ago. Shehnai came due to that Babur. The name was also kept. That hollow stem, that natural hollow stem, it was given the name Shehnai because Nai means barber, and it was played in a Shah's chamber for the first time. So this combination, Nai and Shehnai, was kept when it was first placed in Shah's chamber. And I told you that it is the sound of Shehnai is considered auspicious. It is played in during the time of wedding in Northern India, in North India, and it is, you can hear the Shehnai in temples. But who bought this Shehnai, who had bought this Shehnai to the classical stage, that I mean to say that why this Shehnai become very famous in India? So it became through the great effort of Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now in this lesson we will read about his biography, okay, and you will know a lot of things about Bismillah Khan. And like, he was a 5 year old when he was used to play gulli danda near a pond in Dumra in Bihar. Now earlier, when he was a child, he was interested only in playing gulli danda. It's a Indian game. He would go to the nearby Bihar ji temple to sing the Bhojpuri chaitan. Now his voice was good, so a temple was near his house. And what was the name of the temple? Bihari ji's temple. Generally Bihari ji is the name given to Krishna. So he used to go to that temple and he used to sing in Bhojpuri. And chat was a particular type of song used to be sung in the temple in Bhojpuri. So there he, in Bismillah Khan, he used to come to the temple to sing chaitya. At the end, he would earn a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg. And children, what reward he used to get? He used to get at the end of the होल फंक्शन ही यूज टू गेट ए बिग लड्डू एंड द वेट ऑफ दैट लड्डू वॉज 1 kg 25 g. It was on behalf of the local Maharaja. And who is to give this laddu, who is to distribute this laddu? It was not the emperor, it was the local king. Local Maharaja of Varanasi, he used to distribute it. This happened 80 years ago. So, this happened when? When? It happened 80 years ago. Now children, later on this boy, who is to sing in a small temple, he was awarded and honored by Bharat Ratna. He felt proud to be an Indian and refused many offers given to him by many people in USA and other parts of the world. He was given many offers. People offered him lot of money and they told them to settle in USA to teach the student Shehnai. But he refused because by heart he was an Indian. One great thing about that, he was a Muslim person, but he never used to believe in casteism. The music, the place where he learned the music, it was a temples. Temple was a place where he used to find a lot of peace and he used to give lot of concentration in music. So he never felt that he is a Muslim and he should not go to the temple. So all this thing was not in his mind. He was a true Indian by heart. So in this lesson we will read that when he was born on March 21, 1916, and he was born in a family of musician in Bihar. Children, his grandfather Rasool Bakhsh Khan, he was also a great musician in the court of Bhojpur king, and he also used to play Shehnai. His father Paigambar Bakhsh and other ancestors were great Shehnai player. Not only his grandfather, his grandfather's grandfather, they were also a great Shehnai player. Now, then you will read about Bismillah Khan. At a very early stage of his life, he started learning music. Now, children, when he was only 3 years old, his mother took him to his maternal uncle's house in Benares. Now, when he was 3 years old, he came to Varanasi and here his uncle was living. And his uncle used to practice Shehnai. The small child, the small 3 year old Bismillah Khan, he used to hear Shehnai. And he was so much attracted that he used to go towards his uncle. Soon he started going with his uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Vishnu temple in Varanasi. Now there is one Vishnu temple is there in Varanasi and it was there at that time also. So his uncle Ali Bakhsh used to go at the Vishnu temple to play Shehnai. Soon he started practicing the playing of the instrument. Now children, after playing Shehnai, he became this small child. He was also interested in playing the instrument. And from that year, he was a regular, he used to practice regular, he used to play Shehnai in the temple of Balaji, okay, and at the bank of Ganga. So where he used to practice daily, regularly there. The flowing water of the Ganga inspired him to invent ragas. Now children, when he used to sit near the, at the bank of river Ganga, okay, and when he used to see water, flowing water of Ganga, which he used to feel that water is inspiring him to invent ragas. That means as if Ganga's waves is asking him to invent some more new raga. At the age of 14, now that 3 year child, after practicing near the Ganga bank or inside the temple, now he had become a bit perfect, okay. He was inspired by the waves of Ganga. At the age of 14, Bismillah accompanied his uncle to Allahabad music conference. Now children, once he There was a musical conference in Allahabad, and his uncle was also invited. At that time, Bismillah Khan was only 14 years old. The opening of the All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938 became a big break for him. So he was invited there also, and he was invited to the stage also, and people praised him so much. Not only that, he was given chances to All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938, which was a big break for him. He became a Shehnai player in radio. Now, children, when India became free, I hope you all know that when India became free, it was on August 15, 1947. Okay, so he became the first Indian to greet the nation with his Shehnai. So he was the first one to offer by the Prime Minister that he had to greet the whole nation with the with his Shehnai on August 15, 1947. He played Raag Kafi from Red Fort to people like Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Now, which Raag, which tune he had played? It was Raag Kafi. It is a type of tune which is played while playing instrument. People play Shehnai. And from Red Fort, okay, he was sitting at the base of the Red Fort, and his Shehnai was heard by many people like Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan. King Zahir Shah was deeply impressed by his Shehnai. He gave him priceless Persian carpets. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed that he named his film Goonj Uthi Shehnai. So that film director also was inspired by his Shehnai, and he had made a film Goonj Uthi Shehnai. That film was really a hit at that time. Now, Bismillah Khan music in films did not go beyond Vijay Bhatt Goonj Uthi Shehnai and Vikram Srinivas Kannada film Sananda Apnas. He did not come to terms with the artificiality and glamour of the film world. Now, Bismillah Khan, he was a very simple person. Many film people from Bollywood invited him, but he refused. He did not want to leave his place where his uncle was living in Varanasi, and he loved to play Shehnai. He never want to go the the glamorous word of Bollywood. He loved simplicity. Now, he got many awards, plenty of awards. And at the last, we will read, he got so much award, but the most important award and the honor he got in 2001. Okay. He was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. Then he got many offers in foreign country also. He was invited. He went also there. And there also he made many temples. And now, children, whenever he used to go abroad, he wanted to see India more and more. Sometimes he wanted to see River Ganga. Sometimes he wanted to see his own city, Varanasi. But one thing which always was loved, he always used to love two things in his life. That was his city, Varanasi, and the Holy Ganga. So, Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. It accepts that a Muslim like him can play the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishnu Temple, the famous Kashi Vishnu Temple. Earlier he was called also there in the morning to play Shehnai. So he was honored many times. He was respected by many people, and one thing was clear that he never want to leave Varanasi. He never want to miss the banks of River Ganga. Now, I end my video here. Tomorrow in the third part, we will do the explanation of the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. So here I end. Thank you all for listening me, and have a wonderful day. At the same time, children, please don't miss your studies. You are having a lot of time at home, so please make use of it. Study hard. Reading is the best way. It improves your English. Listening is the best way. So please go through the lesson line wise line. Tomorrow the explanation part will be done. So here I stop. Thank you and have a nice day once again. And bye bye.